I will trust you and obey. When your spirit speaks to me, with my whole heart I'll agree, and my answer will be yes, Lord, yes. I'll say yes, Lord, yes, to your will and to your way. I'll say yes, Lord, yes, I will trust you and obey. When your spirit speaks to me, with my whole heart I'll agree, and my answer will be yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes.
The call to worship. Let us take this moment to become still, turning within, recognizing that there is only one presence, one intelligence in all the universe, and that is God, the good omnipotence. Let's imagine, as we reflect on our power of imagination, knowing that imagination is the faculty of the mind that images and forms. It is the power to shape and form our thoughts. With our imagination, we lay hold of divine ideas and we clothe them with substance. And this moment, as we activate this power within us, we say, thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you for the gift and the power of imagination within us, guiding us to living well. And so it is. Good morning again.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. As we acknowledge, today is the Universal for Better Living Foundation Founders Day. We acknowledge that our spiritual disciple for this month is Bartholomew. The spiritual faculty is imagination, and the color is light blue. The ministry of the month, and I love this name, is Circle of Love. Circle of Love. And so as they continue to impact our spiritual community, reach out to a member and ask them, what do you guys do? And how we could support them and their service and our spiritual community. Let us also send love and appreciation for them expressing the best image at all times of God within each one of them. So we welcome this ministry and the oneness of spirit, knowing that we are all connected as a circle of love. And so it is.
Sing for you today is As We're Sowing. Here we go. As we're sowing, we are reaping. As we're sowing, we are reaping. As we're sowing, we are reaping. Children of the light. Sowing seeds of loving kindness, sowing. bright tomorrow. Sowing now for bright tomorrow. Sowing now for bright tomorrow. Children of the light.
And the next song we're going to do, I know you'll know, so please feel free to sing along with us, is New Age Vision. And you'll recognize it when we start to sing it.
Mine eyes have seen the coming of an age that is to be, when from every limitation I shall know that I am free. For the age is rich in promise, and my soul has eyes to see. God's truth is marching on. Everybody, glory, 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 hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. God's truth is marching on. My soul has seen the beauty of a race from sorrow free, an age of faith and justice, truth and love and liberty. And I sing of love's great triumph in this time of jubilee. God's truth is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. God's truth is marching on. I have seen the freeborn woman standing side by side with man. I have seen the nations brought until there is no tribe or clan. And the warlords all have vanished in the love of man for man. God's truth is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. God's truth is marching on.
So it is.
My name is Allison Griffith. We welcome you to our Sunday spiritual experience here at Verity Centre for Better Living in Toronto, Ontario, Canada. Thank you for joining us this day as we activate our imagination faculty in expressing the best image of God within us. We are a Bible-based New Thought Christian teaching ministry founded by the Reverend Evan Reed. Our senior minister is the Reverend Lemetria D. Hall. We are also a member of the Universal Foundation for Better Living, founded by the Reverend Dr. Johnnie Colemon. And our current president is the Reverend Dr. Sheila McKeithen. If you are joining us for the first time, it is our pleasure to greet you in the spirit of love and hope that something said or done today will make a positive difference in your life. Please know that we accept you, respect you, and appreciate you. We believe that together, as we express our best image of God in 2022, we light the path for others to live a healthy, happy, peaceful, and prosperous life. Our vision is creating and maintaining a spiritually based community that facilitates enlightenment, enrichment, and empowerment. Our mission is offering spiritual-based principles and techniques to those who are seeking to live healthier, happier, and more prosperous lives. Our motto is always verifying the truth, vivifying the spirit, and vitalizing the soul. We offer a full range of sacred little services, theological seminary classes, and life enhancement workshops. There are also opportunities to be an active part of this community. If you have any questions or need to find out more about the center, please visit our website at veritycenter.org or follow us on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and Twitter. We thank you for spending this time with us today. Let us affirm the opening statement together. We are one with God. We are one with all people. We are one with all life. We are one with the One. We are expressing the best image of God in us, and so it is. Our core beliefs. We believe with Jesus that our experiences are the reflections of our beliefs And therefore, the key to happy and successful living is right thinking followed by right action. We believe with Jesus that the basis for right thinking is love. Love of God and all that is good in ourselves and others. We believe that learning to listen to the whispering of the still small voice within us will ensure that we are guided into right action. Today's daily inspirational reading is found on page 67 and will be read by Krishna from the Sunday School.
The common good. When we think more of the common good than we do of our individual good, not only is our own individual good fulfilled, but we discover why we are here, our reason for being. Our own well-being demands that we live in a community way. We cannot live unto ourselves. All the greatness within ourselves is meant to go somewhere, add into expression that blesses others. We are not here to just get, but also to give. What comes to us automatically corresponds to what goes out from us. We each have a job to do, and there is no distinction between the kinds of services that are given by us all. The world needs nurses, doctors, teachers, ministers, politicians, actors, writers, caretakers of home, and children, etc. When the motivation is service, we are free of anger, fear, or doubt, because the law of our being takes care of the details. Today, we salute the Reverend Dr. Johnnie Colemon, who said yes to God in founding the Universal Foundation for Better Living, a teaching vehicle for better living. The scriptural text is taken from Isaiah chapter 56, verse 1. God's message, guard my common good, do what's right, and do it in the right way. And so it is.
Thank you, Krishna. And now for our announcements. The daily call to love meditation continues from Monday to Friday at 7 a.m. The link is in the weekly Verity email. To receive the phone-in information, please leave a message at 416-240-1956. Join us each Sunday for our guided meditation from 10:35 a.m. to 10:45 a.m. Please also send your prayer requests to admin@veritycenter.org. Here are the remaining June series of lessons bringing the Bible alive. Sunday, June 19th, which is Father's Day, Father, Father, Father. Sunday, June 26th, which is T-shirt Sunday, honoring Mary Magdalene. Please wear a POT, AIF, or any other inspirational T-shirt. The 27th anniversary and memorial birthday continues. Campaign continues. The financial goal is $27,000 or more. We thank everyone who has already donated. To date, the fund is at $12,733. We know that God is our source, and with God, all things are possible. The Sunday Zoom experience continues. Until further notice, you will receive the Zoom link in the weekly Verity email. We are, however, encouraging you to return to services at the center, where masks are now optional. The Evan W. Reed Empowerment Academy presents the One Love Laughter Yoga Session with Reverend Lemetria on Sunday, June the 18th, from Saturday, June the 18th, from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. noon at the center, 449 Vaughan Road. There will be a $10 love offering for all participants. Please register today by calling the office or sending an e-transfer. All proceeds support the Evan W. Reed Empowerment Academy. Let's eliminate stress and express healthy living at our best. Lemetria Hall. Verity Games Night is back, and it's happening in person. Join us at the center on Friday, July the 8th at 7 p.m. for a night of fellowship, feast, and fun. Get ready to test your knowledge with games such as trivia, name that tune, bingo, charades, and more. A love offering is welcome. Please invite a friend or two. No registration is required. And this ends our news. The thought for the week. If you fall in love with the imagination, you understand that it is a free spirit. It will go anywhere and it can do anything. Alice Walker. We will now have a musical selection by Shamaray Parkinson.
Good morning, everyone.
To dream the impossible dream and to fight the unbeatable foe, to bear with unbearable sorrow and to run where the brave dare not go. To right the unrightable wrong and to love pure and chaste from afar. To try when your arms are too weary to reach the unreachable star. Well, this is my quest, to follow that star. No matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right without question or pause. To be willing to march into hell for that heavenly cause. And I know if I only be true to this glorious quest, that my heart will lie peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest, and the world will be better for this. That one man scorned and covered with scars, still strove with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable star. Well, this is my quest, to follow that star. No matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right without question or pause. To be willing to march into hell for that heavenly. That one man scorned and covered with scars, still strove with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable.
Thank you.
Tanya. Thank you to Tanya.
Let's get another round of applause. And now our lesson entitled Honoring the Reverend Dr. Johnnie Colemon will be given by the Reverend Lemetria Hall.
Greetings again. Boy, the energy is high up in here. I could just sense through my imagination the Reverend Dr. Johnnie Colemon watching you and listening to you sing one of her favorite songs. Thank you, Shimroy, and thank you, Tanya. I know that you guys had a wonderful Sunday last Sunday with the Reverend Eric O'Donnellson. And so I just want us to acknowledge him, publicly thanking him for starting off our series for the summer of Bible Alive. And I think he really brought it on with the creation story. Did you enjoy that? It was just phenomenal, and I received phone calls and emails of how great it was to experience that. I want us to continue on this journey. I'm asking that throughout the summer, if you could remember, many of us back in the day would pick up our Bible and read it in the morning or read it at night. And many of you now just pick up your phones and you read your Bible in the morning and at night. And so I want us to be in that consciousness of picking up our Bible throughout this summer. Can I get a, you'll do that? Yes. Okay, I didn't get a whole lot, but I'm just asking if you would do that as we bring the Bible alive in our life, in our world, and in our affairs. And it's so amazing as today we are honoring our spiritual founder, the Reverend Dr. Johnnie Colemon. And I thought this was just amazing how we're in the midst of bringing the Bible alive. Because for many of us, it is the legacy of the Reverend Johnnie that brought the Bible alive in a practical way for each one of us to experience the meaning of those stories in our life today. And so I'm so grateful to her, grateful for her energy, grateful for her leadership. And our scripture sets the tone for our honoring of her today. It's taken from Hebrews 13:7. I will be reading from the NIV translation. It says, "Remember your leaders, those who spoke to you the word of God. Consider the outcome of their way of life and imitate their faith." And so we're standing this morning, I know for me personally and many of thousands of individuals, really got to have a more intimate relationship with the Bible through the ministry of the Reverend Dr. Johnnie Colemon. As we think of her as a leader, recognizing that leadership emphasizes influence, someone who has influenced our life, which truly she has influenced this ministry of Verity Centre. There is a book titled Lessons on Living Abundantly. It's a UFBL collaborative work of ministers and teachers and members that have placed reflections and memories about the Reverend Dr. Johnnie Colemon. So in preparing for this lesson, I thought I would go through the book and review it And I went through the book, reviewed it. I had a great time listening to some of the members and teachers and ministers that had written about her. In the beginning, there's a powerful paragraph that I would like to share with you as we think about our great leader, the Reverend Dr. Johnnie Colemon. It says, "There comes a point in every true leader's life at which she, in this case, recognizes that her life is not hers alone and accepts the call to a higher purpose. The realization comes in different forms as different callings for everyone. But one common factor is that the vision and mission are so powerful and clear that the call has no choice but to answer. The spirit becomes willing to shake off the self-serving goals of the personality to pursue only the work of God. And whether anyone else understands or appreciates the vision, the leader moves ever onward towards the mark. The road is not easy, nor is the way straight, but leaders move no matter what. They move beyond the obstacles because mere exercises in their faith and perseverance to the purpose as they are driven as a leader. Every moment that has accomplished anything had to be channeled through the efforts of a willing leader." The willing leader that we are honoring today is the Reverend Dr. Johnnie Colemon. The book talks about her story, and it talks about her ministry. As I take a moment and reflect on her story, many of you have heard, and those who have not heard about her story. It begins with an experience that she becomes a part of, and it's a healing experience. So I always say that our ministry is a foundation of healing, because this is what she experienced to bring herself to answer the call that God had called her to do, which was much more, but she's an actual demonstration of the healing experience. It starts with a story where Johnnie gets a phone call, and Johnnie is told by a medical authority that she had only 6 months to live. And Johnnie hears this, but in her soul, she's not feeling it. And so she's walking in the living room, the home of she and her moms, and a article booklet falls off the table. She picks it up and she looks at it, and what jumps off that page is, "God is my health, I can't be sick." Say it loud. God is my health, I can't be sick. And that was the message that jumped off that page. And as she looked at it and marinated on it, and her soul connected with that message, she began to have a conversation with her mom, talking briefly about it. And then she went on into that conversation where her mother says, "Go to the source of that article where that information came from." And she went on to Unity School of Christianity in Lee Summit, Missouri. She had many experiences there. She went seeking for her soul a healing, and she got much more than that. She got the valleys, she got the mountaintops, she got the all kind of experiences. To name a few, she got to experience what it felt like to be in a religious organization and experience discrimination. So she went through a lot. She was a pioneer for many of us today to lead us in a way that each one of us are learning each day more and more how to live a better life, to experience living peacefully, to experience love in a very, very deeper way. She left Unity and continued on with her studies. And of course, she went beyond those 6 months that she had heard from that medical professional. As her story continues on, Johnnie became an excellent student of truth. And the way that she did that is by putting those principles into practice. She didn't just go to school just to learn and accumulate knowledge. She went to have the experience of understanding that there are principles for better living and principles do not change. And so as Johnnie went on her journey through Unity, she embarked on becoming very much more involved to the point where she began her ministry. And we hear so much about Johnnie starting at a cocktail table, sitting around with a few friends and her mom, and discussing these principles that she was learning about and putting them into practice to discover it truly worked. And as Johnnie went on and began, she was ordained one of, I believe they're listing her now as the third African-American minister to be ordained through Unity. And it was in 1957. And so Johnnie started her ministry, started a church in Chicago. I'm gonna kind of speed it up here a little bit with the story for many of you who have not heard it, but those that have heard it, just go along with me. There is one thing in her story that I want to highlight today because it's very special and it has become relative in my life experience here today. I recently met a young lady prior to coming to Verity Centre, right before I was entering here. And she was actually looking for a laughter yoga experience. She's a physician, a doctor, looking for a place where she could release some stress. And she heard about me and looked me up. And as we were talking, she said, "I noticed as I was researching you, I saw a name that popped out." And she said it was the Reverend Dr. Johnnie Colemon. She said, "Are you connected with Reverend Johnnie in any way?" And I said, "Of course I am." Although we were speaking laughter yoga and I wanted to kind of be a little separated from the Laughter Yoga University for my ministry, I couldn't do it. And so I said, "I am a minister of the Universal Foundation for Better Living. Reverend Dr. Johnnie Colemon, of course, is our founder." And she said, "You know, my family knew her well." And I said, "Really?" And so she went on to tell me the story about she was telling me many stories about her family because they were well connected with Reverend Johnnie. But there was one individual, when she said Esther, my heart jumped. And I was like, wow, that's the minister that we heard about. Many of us have never seen because Reverend Esther was with Johnnie from the very beginning. Reverend Esther was Johnnie's first assistant minister of Christ Unity Temple in Chicago, right there with Johnnie, side by side, step by step, helping her to start the ministry with the group of people that were around. I brought a picture. And when I came in this morning with the picture, people were looking at it saying, "Is that Reverend Dr. Johnnie Colemon or is that Reverend Johnnie?" And I'm like, "No, it's not Reverend Johnnie. It's Reverend Esther. It's Reverend Esther Stewart Leeton, Johnnie's first assistant minister that worked with her side by side." And that story in the book, it mentions that Reverend Johnnie was given an assignment to go to Trinidad to be a visiting minister there for a month with the Reverend Robinson. And she got there because Reverend Robinson was going on a sabbatical journey in Africa, and his assistant minister was the Reverend Donette Ned. The Reverend Donette Ned. I'm sure many of you, I got some smiles coming, who became Johnnie's second husband, Reverend Ned, who wrote the statements of faith, our what we believe statements. And so Johnnie connected with him back then. This is back in the 60s, guys. And so Johnnie spent a month there, and while she was there, Reverend Esther was taking care of all the ministry business at home in Chicago at Christ Unity Temple. While Reverend Esther was fulfilling the duties that Johnnie left with her, something happened. Mother's Day of 1965, Reverend Esther was killed by her husband. So it was a domestic violence situation that was taking place then. And with her being a part of the ministry and very involved and working side by side with Johnnie all the way, her moment in the physical realm was interrupted. But her spirit continues on. And I was so happy and grateful to my friend, Dr. Russia Butler, for bringing this picture. She brought it all the way to Toronto. She wanted to present it to me at my installation, but she was not able to be there then, but she bought me the picture. And so to have this connected with Reverend Johnnie, part of our legacy, is very important. One of the things that Johnnie did as soon as she came back from Trinidad to be with her spiritual family and with the family of Reverend Esther, she started a campaign. It was a memorial campaign in Reverend Esther's honor. And that started, and it expanded the church. The church was a jewel box, which was could take the maximum of about 500 seated guests on a Sunday. And after this campaign, it grew to a 1,200 room. They added another wing to it. And so a lot of people don't know about this story, and I thought it was very appropriate today to acknowledge one of the individuals that stood right by Johnnie all the way until the end of her physical life expression. And so I wanted to honor her. Her family is watching us from different places, from Chicago, from Maryland and other places this morning. And we just want to thank each one of you there online for joining us. As I mentioned to them that we would be acknowledging her today, because a leader does not do everything by themselves. Hello? There has to be a team. Has to be a team. And there's always someone assisting. And so I wanted to just acknowledge those that are assisting. I walked in this morning and one of my assistant ministers that didn't know that they were one of my assistant ministers was really shocked and surprised when I was sharing the story with him, and I said, Tracy, you are one of my assistant ministers. And he chuckled. He said, Reb, really? I said, yeah, let's high five on it. Because a leader cannot do it by themselves. There's a team. Jesus had a team of assistant ministers. He had 12 in this category. He had 12 in other categories. And he had many other categories that we have not even heard about. But it was a team. And so I wanted to thank all of the members of Johnnie's team for bringing us to where we are here today. And so as I go into Johnnie's legacy, and that which she brought so alive in our lives, we stand on 9 statements of faith. And I was inspired to write statements of faith according to Reverend Johnnie, written by Reverend Lemaitre. And so this morning, if you're writing with me, and it will be recorded, so we will have it, let us go through these statements of faith that was left with us through the legacy and the work of this amazing woman, the Reverend Dr. Johnnie Colemon. Love to be called Johnnie. And so the first statement is that I learned from Reverend Johnnie, bringing this statement alive in my life. It says, I am made in the image and likeness of God. Therefore, I am God. In the beginning, God, in the end, God, in between, God, God is all there is. That's a statement that Johnnie lived by. To the point where when I first heard it out of her mouth, I covered my head. And I said, God, that's her talking about you, not me. I thought it was a statement of blasphemy. How could one say, I am God? And I understand that statement now. I am made in the image and likeness of God. Therefore, I am God. Hello? I am made in the image. Johnnie practiced, Johnnie preached, Johnnie taught. And so when she say, I am God, today, Lemetria understands. And I hope each one of you understand that each one of us are made in God's image. We are individual expressions of God's image. And so we all express in a unique way. My way is not your way, and your way is not my way. We have all been called on a divine purpose to express our individuality of God within us. And our claim for this year, our theme for this year, is express your best. That's all we're asking of each one of us. Express your best. And so Johnnie's statement that she stood on of being in the image and likeness of God, expressing God in many, many ways, and she has done so much. And the thing about it, to bring the Bible alive in a way that is practical for us to understand, to put to use, that's what Johnnie stands for. Her second statement is on healing. You can heal yourself. She even wrote a book about it. Open your mind to be healed. It brings up emotions in me. My mother was an amazing woman, but she had one experience in her life as it related to education. She only went to, I think she said, the 9th or 10th grade. And so what I discovered about my mother, which was so amazing, that I got to witness the first true book that she had ever read. And that book was Open Your Mind to Be Healed. And to watch my mother meditate on the words, I don't know what Johnnie said in that book, but it was during my mom going through a time of healing. And she experienced it by reading that book. And so Johnnie touched so many people. Her own healing story is amazing. And many stories, to the degree I'm sitting in a dentist's office who knew I was a member of Christ Universal Temple. I had had much surgery, and going for a checkup one day, I opened my mouth and he was working with it, and the first thing that came out of his mouth was, that Johnnie Colemon is something else. And I went, really? I'm thinking, he was acknowledging how my mouth was doing so well. And he didn't say, you, Lemetria. He said, Johnnie Colemon. Johnnie Colemon. Her legacy touched so many people. And so the next statement of faith for Johnnie is, prosperity is your birthright. She was Miss Prosperity in Chicago, and it overflowed into every other place in the U.S. and across the borders. She emphasized, I am prosperity. And she was always saying how it was important for her to look her best and feel her best. And it wasn't necessary about the outer appearances that people were stunned by when they saw her. It was her presence. When she walked in the room, I had an opportunity. It's amazing, and I'm backing up a minute. When you guys were singing a song, As We Are Sowing, We Are Reaping, it made me think about her in that area of prosperity. She wasn't just learning prosperity principles, she was putting them into practice. And so it's important that we do that. Put it into practice. And so with working with that, watching her, I remember we used to say in Chicago, and there was a saying, oh, I know that church over there where it's thousands of members there, it's all about prosperity. Well, I didn't know until I got there what she was talking about, because from the outside looking in, it was a part of what the naysayers were saying. But once I got in there, I understood that prosperity from what she was preaching to us was more about the inner man than the outer man. It was more about, could you imagine, just imagine, and I'm imagining it right now, just being in a peaceful state of mind at all times. Even as the song was mentioning in the Impossible Dream, go to hell to experience heaven. As you're going through whatever is going on, you're not moved by it because you are the image and likeness of God. You are experiencing peaceful living. Statement number four. She says, you can have as far as you can see. She says, dream big. I think I started dreaming at 30. Started dreaming at 30. Dreaming. I was watching a movie preview, and I can't talk much about it, but I could talk about the person who wrote it, and that's Nicole, one of our members. It's a dream that is a part of her that is coming into fruition, and I'm asking that we as a spiritual community hold her in the light and support her as this dream flourishes and reaches millions of individuals. There's some heavy messages in there. The fifth statement of faith Johnnie lived by. I am the thinker who thinks the thought that makes the thing. She took this principle to a deeper level, had many of us understanding what it means. I was watching some series in Star Wars with my husband just this week. And I thought, as New Thought Christians, we are the Jedis. Y'all got it? Do you imagine how much power is within us? We could actually move objects. We have that power, and it is done. There is so much in us. And it's amazing what you could do. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. As you carry these thoughts, as you put form to it using your power of imagination, you could accomplish and achieve anything you choose. Johnnie says, it works if you work it. She says, I'm the thinker who thinks the thoughts that makes the thing. This is another statement that is very powerful that I remember about Reverend Johnnie. Number six, it says, I am unique, unrepeatable, and special being. She demonstrated authenticity. Be yourself. Be yourself. You can't copy nobody else anyway. Be yourself. Be authentic. Keep it simple. Do you. Be you. When you are doing you and being you, guess what? Others see the true light, your divine expression. When you're being somebody else, they call it. They say, look at her acting like so-and-so. Look at him acting like Mr. So-and-so. But when you are being yourself, they feel you. They know that it's something unique about you because you are unique, unrepeatable, and you are a special being. Her last statement, which we all said it earlier, and she wrote a book about this too, it works if you work it. She demonstrated. She has so many demonstrations that she has laid before us. She says, I know it works because I've worked it for myself. She lived beyond the 1950 whatever experience to be of a grand age, 94 years young. So she lived beyond that. She says, I know it works because I've worked it for myself. How many of us can truly say right now we know something works? We know it works. Each one of us is standing as a demonstration of it works if you work it. And so I'm asking you, to bring the Bible alive in your life. Don't get caught up in the literal statements. Go deeper as a metaphysician. Go deeper. This woman, I'm telling you, I came and just to hear the Ten Commandments in a new way. The Ten Commandments, when she taught them, for me to hear it for the first time, I couldn't believe it. Even with thou shall not commit adultery. I remember doing a lesson on that I was just amazed by, because I understood it wasn't about who somebody was sleeping with in the physical realm. It was about who are we sleeping with when we go to bed. Are we going to bed with fear? Are we going to bed with doubt? Are we going to bed with discriminating thoughts in our mind? Those are the things that I'm talking about. Bring the Bible alive, where you could go to sleep in peace, go to sleep with love, and you will not be committing adultery. You will be expressing your true, authentic self as the image and likeness of God. And so I leave you with this statement. Dream big. Dream big. Dream big and express the best image of God in you now. And so it is.
We're gonna celebrate and hope you can celebrate with us. Here we go. It's up to you. What's your let me hear you say, celebrate good times, come on, let's celebrate now. Well, there's a party going on right here, a celebration to last throughout the year. So bring your good times and your laughter too. We're gonna celebrate your party with you. Come on, Verity, celebration. Let's all celebrate and have a good time. Come on now, celebration. We're gonna celebrate and have a good time. It is time to come together. It's up to you. What's your pleasure, everyone? Around the world, come on, celebrate good times, come on, let's celebrate now, one more time, let me hear you say, celebrate good times, come on.
For many of you, if you don't know what we're celebrating
the birth of the Universal Foundation for Better Living. Over 46 years. So come on, world, celebrate with us. Experience these principles for yourself to know that it truly works when you work it. So we just say thank you, God. As we prepare now in a mighty, mighty way, Johnnie was a generous giver. She understood as we are sowing, we are reaping. And so for all of us right now, if we could just pause, take a moment, as we turn within and give from our hearts. And however way you choose to give to this ministry, is it through mailing it to our mailing address or sending an e-transfer through our email address, or if it's using the mobile app Titherly or Canada Helps, we are so ever grateful. We thank you for your generosity. And so we affirm together as we give our statement of thanksgiving. We say, divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I give, all that I have, and I'm saying it all in my own way. Let's do it one more time. Okay. Together, divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. And so it is. Amen. All is well. Yeah, I get excited when it comes to giving. I heard the campaign notice of 12,000. We got to make sure next month it says 14,000. So join me, guys, as we move it up a little bit higher in our giving. Thank you, God. Any reminders that I'm supposed to give? I want to make sure that everyone knows that laughter yoga will be on site. Okay, on Saturday the 18th, come on out and just let go of all the stresses of the world, even if it's not yours, let go of others. And enjoy us as we are working on laughing for better health and better living. We also know that Renee is not with us today, that I will be hosting a short fellowship after we end the service with the people that are online. And so people on site, stay and enjoy with us as well. And if there's anything else that I have not mentioned, please follow our e-blast, follow the announcements that were mentioned earlier. I am so excited to be back. I don't know what to do. It's like, am I forgetting something or missing something? I'm just so happy to see all of you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And so as we conclude our service for today, we all let us stand that are here and those that are watching us join in with us as we affirm our closing statement together. Together, please. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. And the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is. Wherever I am, God is. And so it is. Thank you. And this concludes our service for the Universal Foundation for Better Living, Founders Day Sunday. Thank you and God bless. All right.
Oh, so I'm going to pull up the chat. Sorry, I didn't mean to do that.